This is the greatest and best drone script in the world. Tribute. Long time ago, me and my drone son Buster here, we was flying down a long and Wi-Fi-less field. All of the sudden, a demon possessed Buster as I went to SSH into him in the middle of the field. And he said, connect to me without your home Wi-Fi or I'll eat your souls. Well, me and myself, we looked at each other and we each said, okay. And we found a way to SSH in the field, away from home Wi-Fi. It's with a thing called mobile hotspots. It's with a thing called mobile hotspots. I look into Buster's eyes and it's easy to see. Mobile hotspots in the field with me. It is destiny. But you know, special shout out to Jack Black and Kyle Gass of Tenacious D for writing that beautiful intro. Really special stuff. Those guys, me and them go way, way back. But you know, back to the topic of the video. So I'm sure you've been there, and if you haven't and you're watching this, then you can now avoid that. But okay, you write some super awesome script for your Raspberry Pi. You then go away from your home Wi-Fi, and then you realize there's no way to access your Pi to run the script. So the solution we are proposing here in this video is mobile hotspots, as Jack Black and Kyle Gass just told us. So with just a smartphone and a Pi, you can get wireless access for those times you won't have access to your normal wireless network. So you can go out in the field, got a script on your drone you want to run, now you can just set up a little network on your phone, connect your Pi to it, connect your laptop, boom, you can access your drone and start any scripts that you need to get it going. So let's get into it.
So quick, let's go over a description of the problem. So the key part, the key feature, the pro of having a Raspberry Pi on the drone is the ability to write your own custom missions, your own custom Python scripts on the Raspberry Pi. That will be able to control the drone. For example, taco delivery or precision landing with an Aruco marker, with OpenCV, all that stuff is on the Raspberry Pi. Well, when you're out in the field, away from your wireless network at your house, how are you going to log on to your Raspberry Pi? And, you know, it's kind of a difficult thing. And you need to be able to log into your Raspberry Pi, because how else are you going to trigger those scripts? You have to be SSH'd, logged into the Raspberry Pi in order to run those scripts. So it's kind of a problem whenever you go out into an open field and you leave your router behind, because that's how a typical wireless network works. You know, you connect a bunch of devices to the router, and the devices don't communicate directly, they communicate through the router. So when you're out in the field, all of a sudden it's a difficult problem to connect your laptop with your drone's Raspberry Pi. And like I already said, here's a nice diagram of showing you that there is not a router while you are out in the field. So one of the solutions that we have been promoting here at the Drone Dojo for a while has been ad hoc networking. And that is for a simple reason. See, with the router internet networks, the devices don't communicate directly. The laptop doesn't communicate with the Raspberry Pi. It routes through the router. With ad hoc networking, the devices can communicate directly. So that is why this method is kind of attractive when you are trying to run some drone operations away from any wireless networking. And you know, it works pretty good, but there are a few problems with ad hoc networking, and that is what we're going to be talking about here. Ad hoc networking is becoming sort of a difficult difficult piece of a difficult feature to find on a wireless network adapter. So, you know, like a Linksys or a little USB dongle that you plug into a computer. More and more, it's becoming very difficult to find an adapter capable of ad hoc networking, even to the point where, like, I've had to order adapters from, like, 2010 that aren't being made anymore, but I know that they are still capable of ad hoc networking. So it's hard. One, the first problem is it's hard to get your hands on the adapter. And the second thing is it takes a ton of setup steps on the Raspberry Pi before you can get ad hoc networking up and running. So it's not just a plug and play thing. While it does work, and it works good whenever it's set up, it can be a real pain in the you-know-what before you get to that successful ad hoc networking. So there is another solution, and that is what we are going to be talking about in this video. Since there are so many unnecessarily difficult steps with ad hoc networking, one of our Drone Dojo members, hat tip to Photon John, said that he set up a different method of networking in the field, and that is utilizing mobile hotspots. So mobile hotspots are pretty cool. They differ from ad hoc networks because, you know, the laptop and the Raspberry Pi won't be communicating directly. But with a mobile hotspot, think of your phone replacing the router. So it's essentially the same setup, only you're replacing the router for the phone. So basically, almost any smartphone is capable of having a mobile hotspot. And it's very, very, it's just flat out superior to ad hoc networking for a couple reasons. The first one is it's extremely simple to set up. There's no like super techie steps that you need to take to set up mobile hotspots. It's very simple, and there's no special hardware required. So, I mean, almost anyone these days has access to a smartphone, so once you know how to set up a mobile hotspot, internet connectivity out in the field when you need to log on to your Raspberry Pi won't be a problem anymore. So essentially, you know, your phone is going to broadcast a Wi-Fi connection. So, you know, when you pull up your little wireless networks that are available to you, you see all these SSIDs or the names of the networks that you can connect to. Nacho Wi-Fi, pretty good. So whenever your mobile hotspot is set up, that will be displayed here in this list of networks that you can connect to. So then all you would need to do is connect your Raspberry Pi to that network, connect the laptop that you're using in the field to that network, and now, voila, your laptop can communicate with your Raspberry Pi, and it will do that through the phone. So in the rest of this video, I'm going to show you how you can set up your own mobile hotspot so you can easily get internet connectivity out in the field. Now, there are going to be four steps in this video. The first is going to be setting up the mobile hotspot on the phone. The second is setting up the Raspberry Pi to automatically connect to the mobile hotspot. There's a couple different ways of doing this. And then, very simply, we just have to connect the hotspot on the laptop, and then we'll just SSH into the Raspberry Pi, and then you'll be good to go. So I will be setting up or using a Samsung phone for demonstration in this video, mainly because, you know, it's just a better phone than Apple. Don't at me, all you Apple people. I'm sorry. Just a Samsung guy. But if you do have an iPhone, go ahead and check out this link here, and it is a good piece of documentation to show you how to set up a mobile hotspot on your phone, but it's very similar to how to do that on a Samsung. So if you have any questions about that, just let me know, and I'll help you walk through that on the iPhone. So let's jump over to the Samsung.
All right, so now let's set up that mobile hotspot. Again, I'm on a Samsung phone. It should be pretty similar on an iPhone, but, you know, Samsungs are way better. But we have to go to settings and then go to connections. Now look at mobile hotspot and tethering. Here we're just going to turn that on. And then there's a couple things we have to configure. So once we have that turned on, go ahead and click into that. And here's where we can do some customizations. So if you want to change the name of your mobile hotspot network, you can do that here. Name it whatever you want. And this will be the name that'll show up, like, you know, when you're looking at wireless networks on your menu that you want to connect to. This will be the name that you see. Then you can set the password here as well. So at this point, this network is visible. So your Raspberry Pi would be able to connect to it. Your laptop would be able to connect to it. So let's go ahead and set up our Raspberry Pi to connect to whatever you name the network and then enter in the password.
We're just going on a walk, bro. All right? Don't worry about it. You can go on through.
All right, now we have our mobile hotspot set up and activated on our phone. Now let's go ahead and configure our Raspberry Pi to connect to that mobile hotspot. So you can do this in a couple different ways. Basically, you just need to get access to the Raspberry Pi. So one way would be to do this by inserting the SD card into an SD card reader, putting it on your computer, and setting up the internet that way. That's what we're going to do in this video. But alternatively, you could also connect your Pi to a screen via HDMI cables, because this doesn't actually require an internet connection. Or you could connect your Raspberry Pi to the router via a Ethernet cable, and you could find your IP address that your Raspberry Pi got and then SSH into your Raspberry Pi and set up your Raspberry Pi to connect to the internet with that. But we are, like I said, going to do method one. But if you use either method two or three, you can basically do the same thing I'm doing in this video, only you're going to need to edit the file at /etc/wpasupplicant/wpasupplicant.conf. So you'll just edit that file directly on your Raspberry Pi, instead of just on the SD card like I'm doing here. So I have already inserted the SD card of the Raspberry Pi in or onto my computer. And just to show you guys, here we go. The mobile hotspot is active right now, Dojo phone. And let's go ahead and configure our Raspberry Pi to connect to that automatically. So you're going to want to go to the boot directory, and this is like almost identical to setting up your internet in a headless fashion. That means without needing access to the Raspberry Pi. Look for a file named wpa_supplicant.conf. If it's not there, right-click, hit new, text document, and then highlight the whole thing and name it wpa_supplicant.conf. Hit yes, and then we're going to go into that file. And here is a template of what you need in WPA Supplicant. So copy this stuff. If you're in a different country than the United States, go ahead and find that country code. But here is what we're going to be focused on, the network portion. So the SSID is just simply the name of your mobile hotspot. So mine is Dojo Phone. And then the password goes here. And I believe, let me go ahead and let's see what that password was. SSOU5175. So I'm going to save that. And let's eject the SD card from the computer. And now, whenever we plug in our SD card into the Raspberry Pi and power it up, it should automatically connect to the mobile hotspot whenever the mobile hotspot is activated. Okay, then once we power on our Raspberry Pi, after setting it up to connect to the mobile hotspot, we can see if we were successful. And so we can go, the easiest way to do that would be on the phone. Just go back to mobile hotspots, and then you will look for the connected devices section. So in my case, you can see there is the Raspberry Pi. Now it might take a little bit of time for the Raspberry Pi to get connected to the mobile hotspot after you power it on. So maybe wait a couple minutes before you determine whether or not it was successful. But once you see the Raspberry Pi there, you can click on it and you can get the address, the IP address. So my phone is telling me the Raspberry Pi now has an IP address of 192.168.43.47. So we will keep that in mind whenever we want to connect our laptop to that or our computer. So that is the next step. So here I am on the computer now. And very simply, I'm just going to look for... Oh, I'm already connected. Let's disconnect that. And connect to Dojo Phone or whatever your mobile hotspot is. And now you should see another connected device on your mobile hotspot list. Okay, so after that is done, our laptop and our Raspberry Pi are on the same network. So what does that mean? Well, very simply, we should be able to easily SSH into the Raspberry Pi now. So the IP address was 192.168.43.47. We'll hit open here, and there we go. This is going to be our terminal of the Raspberry Pi, and it's all happening through our phone with the mobile network. So login is Pi, password is Raspberry, and we're in. So you could easily do this operation out in the field, and it's the process of setting up your Raspberry Pi to connect to the mobile hotspot only needs to be done once. So it should be very easy once you have everything set up and running. Let's go ahead and look at the IP address on the Pi. So there it is, 192.168.43.47. And let's pull up a terminal for our computer just so we can show you that we are on the same network. So if config, here's the computer I'm on. So it's 192.168.43.17.
So that's the end of the video. I hope this helps you when you're testing your own Raspberry Pi drone scripts or just a Raspberry Pi script out in the field and you don't have a wireless network to connect to. I hope this helps you out. Oh, and speaking of Raspberry Pi drones, if you're interested in programming your own Raspberry Pi drone without, you know, having to go through the hassle of finding all the right parts, making sure they all cooperate, making sure all the parts work, then at the Drone Dojo, we have Raspberry Pi Hawk drone kits with everything pre-selected, all the parts pre-tested so you know it works. All you have to do is put it together and you're ready to go. It's really just like a creativity machine that can take ideas out of your head, put them onto a drone, and you're flying those things. It's pretty cool. So if you want one, check that out. It should be a thing you can click somewhere. And you know, the theme of this video was Tenacious D. Let me know in the comments what the theme of the next video should be, and I might check that out for the next video. So until next time, I don't know why I did that. I need to sign off, but until next time, we'll see you.